that are pretty resilient.
Gophers are pretty resilient.
Yeah, they are. They are. I mean, again, they got a great team. They got a great bunch of kids, and they are resilient. It's a tough building to play in, and again, we played our hearts out tonight. And again, it's a tough pill to swallow right now. Obviously, again, because you know we had a lead. Sorry about that, Jess. We had a lead. I think our players felt it. I know I felt it on the bench. Even it was 3-3. I felt really good, and I think you guys know what I'm talking about when you say if you feel it. You know, I felt it, and but they're resilient, and they put their foot on the gas pedal for the last 15 minutes, and again, they just, they delivered, they got it done, and again, it's a sign of a championship team.
Walsh has been so good all weekend and all season for you. The game winner is just kind of a simple backhand where it looks like he's got the post covered, you know. Surprising?
I didn't see the goal. I haven't looked at it yet, Jess, so I don't want to comment on that. I don't want to comment on something I haven't seen.
But you got to love the way you played. Gave you a chance to win.
One more time, I'm sorry.
But you got to love the way you played. He gave you a chance to win both games this week.
Absolutely. He did give us a chance to win. Well, she played good, but I'll tell you, I thought we had 20 guys who played well. I thought we pushed the pace. We had plenty of scoring chances. I thought the kid over in their net played pretty darn good as well.
You guys were able to get more balanced scoring. I know we talked about that a little bit. It's probably the first time in a couple weeks we were able to get scoring from all three.
It's nice getting three goals, period, let alone against these guys in their building. You know, and again, typically, college hockey, first team of three wins. We were the first team of three, and we didn't get it done. But again, this is a team that has the ability of putting up four on a consistent basis, and they're one of the few teams in the country that can put up four on a consistent basis. So. Again, hats off to the team we played.
That third goal of yours, 15 seconds or whatever, after they started to build some momentum.
Yeah, it was huge. And again, I thought it showed a lot of character. And speaking of resiliency, I thought that our guy showed some resiliency. You know, instead of being down and out, again, we responded. And we responded extremely positive, extremely positively. And again, it was nice to get that goal and go up 3-1. And again, then that was a little backbreaker at the end of the second right there. And, that was a tough one as well. I think that was deflected, wasn't it? That was a tough goal. But again, we still had a lead going into the third.
What do you take from a game like this and build it for next year?
Oh, I don't want to think about it right now. I mean, you guys are asking questions that, I mean, you're too far ahead of me right now. But, again, it's just nice to, we played well. We flat out played well. And again, it's good for our young kids. It's good for our older guys, even the guys who are leaving. We just played well, and again, it's too bad. Again, too bad that there was no result to show for it because when we played, I thought we just played a very good hockey game tonight. Last night we played well, but again, they probably dictated the play for about 70 minutes last night. Where I thought again, there were stretches where we played extremely well, and we kind of carried the play.
You played the last four games against some of the best teams in the country. Three of them were one-goal games. You proud of your guys, the way they finished it off the year?
Absolutely, I'm proud of our guys. Absolutely, I'm proud of our guys. And, again, I thought they responded, and they played their hearts out.